Hey, aren't you gonna include me in your selfie?
What the heck? Why are you here?
Stay tuned, because I'll show you how with blend modes. Hey everyone, George from Filmora, here to empower your inner video creator. So you may have heard of blending modes if you use Photoshop before. What you might not know is that our editing software Filmora lets you do the same thing, but for videos. Yep, that's right. You can layer pretty much any video together with another seamlessly by using the same options you got in Photoshop. What is a blending mode? A blend mode lets you combine your clips together using its preset settings like transparency, color values, and brightness. There are a lot of blending modes to choose from, but the one you end up choosing will depend on the context of your video and the files you want to use. In this video, I'm going to show you a handful of creative ways to use blending modes to make your videos more unique. Alright, so I'm going to show you how to add blending modes to that picture frame example. So what I'm going to do first is put the clip of JJ next to the picture frame on the topmost layer. This is the layer that you won't change when adding blending modes. And then for the one where the picture comes out, where I'm in the picture, I'll put that on the PIP layer. And this is the one that I can blend in the topmost layer. And then you're gonna wanna click on that bottommost layer and see where these, all of the outside points are. You can drag them to move the clip. So in this case, I want it to be around the picture frame. But what I do notice is that it's actually a bit too wide for my picture frame, so that when I go in to actually blend it together in the blending modes, it's going to be too wide and not work out. So before I actually get this to work, I'm gonna have to put this clip that I want inside the picture frame on my topmost layer. All right, let's crop the video frame. So put the picture that you wanna crop on the topmost layer, right click on it, and select crop and zoom. Here you'll want to constrain this picture manually so that you can really move these points around wherever you want. And I'm going to try to emulate the picture frame size as best as possible. And that should be about right. So before you're ready, make sure to take note of these numbers here. This is what you're going to want to export your dimensions of your video as. So 2499 by 2160. I'm gonna remember that. And when I go to export this clip, I'm gonna go in my settings and I'm gonna select the resolution custom and add that resolution in. Okay, so I realized I should have wrote down this these crop and zoom settings here before exporting my clip. But luckily enough, I made a version earlier, so let's just go with that. Let's put JJ on the topmost layer again. And let's put that clip I exported with the crop on the second most layer. So now before you do any blending, you're going to want to resize this clip that you cropped as best as you can into the picture frame. It's okay if you have to, you know, squish it a little bit for the purpose of this skit. For the sake of timing, I'm probably not going to be able to do this perfectly. Make sure when you're resizing into the picture frame, you really fine-tune the edges. So once I'm satisfied with that, I'm going to right-click on the PIP layer, click Advanced Edit, and in the Compositing tab, this is where you find all your blending modes. And the one that I found works best for this picture frame is the Darken mode. It kind of removes the sides of the picture, allowing it to fit perfectly into the picture frame. And there you go. Now I'm in the picture frame. So the next example I call the logo punch out. It's a cool way to add a logo animation even if your logo is not animated. So what I've done is I put a Wondershare logo in the topmost layer of the Filmora timeline. And what I'm gonna do is I'm going to put like a cool texture, video texture of bubbles, paint bubbles in this PIP layer. And this is the one I'm going to blend into the logo. But before I can do that, I have to trim the clip down so that it starts at the right point. And then because the size of the logo is a little bit smaller than the size of this picture in the PIP layer, I'm gonna have to select its edges and move them so that they perfectly match the size of the picture above. And this is a lot like matching the picture frame with the person in it. Once I'm happy with the size of the PIP layer, I'm gonna right-click on it, go into Advanced Edit to set up the blending modes in the Compositing tab. And then I'm gonna select one that works for this particular example. I really like the way the linear dodge makes this logo animate, so I'm gonna choose that one. I'm gonna show you what it looks like. Check it out. Just like that, you have a cool logo animation. For the last example, I'm gonna show you how you can darken overexposed shots or video clips using the blending modes in Filmora. I have this example of a building that's a bit overexposed, so I'm gonna layer it on top of itself so I can blend it, making it a bit darker. I'm gonna right click on the PIP layer, and in the compositing tab, I'm gonna choose the multiply blending mode. And as soon as I can do that, you can see the exposure on the building is softened and it looks a bit darker. You could also adjust the opacity if it's not quite perfect. And there you go. I'm a lot happier with this image now. So this is just a taste of what you can do with blending modes. There are a ton more you can discover by modifying different layers. Hope these tips help you get some amazing results out of Filmora. If you don't have it yet, you can try it free by clicking on the link in the description box below. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, because we're uploading filmmaking tutorials every week. I'll see you next time.